Hello, I'm going to explain a little bit more about green liberalism and liberalism in general. Generally, it's not what I'd like to explain that the liberalism has also an opposite, the opposite of liberalism, and people are not, it's not often that they are contrasted. So I'd like to contrast liberalism with the opposing term, which is called paternalism. From the Latin word pater means father. That means that someone else, father, decides how you should live your life. So, and actually, the default modus of humankind is paternalism. In all history, in all cultures, there has been paternalism. Paternalism is the rule. Liberalism is the exception. Paternalism means that usually the person in power, usually the man, decide what other people have to do and how they have to live their life. So paternalism is limiting individual freedom. Something exceptional happened in the history of humanity since the Enlightenment in the 18th century. Since then, the ideal of individual freedom has come up, which has led to liberalism. So, but it's clear that we should acknowledge and know that the default modus of humanity is paternalism, and that liberalism is very, very exceptional. And it also has taken a long time in the history of humanity to get where we are now. Sometimes also it is forgotten how exceptional it is to be at a university in which there are men and women. It doesn't matter who your parents are, doesn't matter what your sexual orientation are, doesn't matter what your background is, what your skin color is, and that is very good in my opinion. But that comes from the liberal project of the Enlightenment. And that is very exceptional in the history of humanity. Although, by the way, it's also irrelevant at university whether or not you're religious. And that's also something which is very exceptional. So it is something to be proud of, something to celebrate, something to be aware how exceptional it is that we live in a liberal time. Actually, it is within our lifetime, in the year 2001, was like a marker in the history of humankind. In 2001, in the Netherlands, for the first time in history, there was equal rights for people of the same sex to marry. So, up till then, paternalistic tendency was that the majority, and the majority of people are heterosexual, they limited the freedom of gay people to live a lifestyle they want to live for themselves. So 2001 in the Netherlands and 2002 in Belgium, and from there it went on. But that's really a breaking point in the history of liberalism. So, and still you can see that even in the liberal societies in the Netherlands, there are still some paternalistic groups and tendencies and ideologies who want to limit the freedom of individuals, of gay people or of people of different color or religion, whatever. So that's important to notice that liberalism is very exceptional. But liberalism is also, it's also good to know that there can be in-group paternalism. So there's a difference between giving liberalism to groups or to the individual. And that is actually the problem of multiculturalism. In a multicultural society, is who should the government give freedom? Should we give and protect individual freedom, or should we protect the freedom of groups? Generally, there is a tendency in liberal society to give freedom to groups. So that we have in the Netherlands, that we have Jewish schools, a lot of Christian schools, and a few Islamic schools. But by doing that, we are allowing paternalism in schools, within groups, under the cloak of liberalism. And I think that is a misunderstanding, that we should take the core of liberalism to always look at the and protect the freedom of the individual, and not to let by multiculturalism paternalistic tendencies limit individuals. So although we live in a liberal society, it is very important to keep on fighting off paternalism, and to be very aware, and maybe also be glad that we live in this society.